Hey everybody, so I'm back to film a quick haul video. We'll really see how quick this is gonna be. And I know I'm gray on gray on gray right now. I went to Target and recently picked up a bunch of stuff. Some things were repurchases and some things were just new purchases. A lot of things just to review, really. And then I have a few clothing things to show you guys. So I guess I'll take the clothing things out of the way because it's really not that much stuff. So this was actually supposed to be a separate outfit of the day video, but these are a bunch of new things that I'm wearing in this video that I decided to include in. It's all from Daily Look. I got this new gray sweater with these little cutouts, and it's longer in the back than it is the front. It has a little diamond symbol on it. I thought it was cute, comfy, and casual. I wore it to the mall. These really, really bright neon skinnies that fit really well. And these super, super cute black ankle booties that you can wear up or folded down. I like them folded down, so that's how I wore them. And for some reason, the socks I was wearing with my pajamas prior to changing matched perfectly with my outfit, like at least a little bit. But don't judge me. Definitely check out Daily Look. They have really, 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 really cute stuff. I have been obsessed with blazers lately. I have a new one that I got through hauler deals. I have a new one. Well, that's not new. I have another one that's from Daily Look that's like my coral one that I've been wearing a lot lately. I got that like last year. This is my new green one. It's very cute. No, I'm not obsessed with green. It just so happens everything is green right now in the video. Another thing from Daily Look is this belt. It was actually a lot smaller than I thought it was going to be, but it's a really cute, this red and gold belt, nice and slim. I don't have a belt that is this slim or like something that you could wrap around, like, you know, like a dress or something like that. So this was nice. A very quick and easy pickup. I picked up a bunch of stuff from Target last night. Or was it two nights ago? Roughly either two nights ago or last night. I think it was two nights ago, to be honest. I don't even remember anymore. I will link off prices and everything down below for you to check out if you want to check Daily Look out. So the next thing, I posted a picture on Instagram and they were like the most awesome sneaker wedges ever. Look at them. Aren't they gorgeous? Oh, I got these from Zara. I purchased them online because I didn't really feel like searching for my size in store. So I purchased them online. They were free shipping anyway. I still have a tag on them. I haven't worn them yet. I only tried them on because they just came in like a couple days ago. But they're really nice because they're not too slim. I have a pair of Steve Madden sneaker wedges as well. And those were in really, really slim. Even though my feet are slim, so it's not that big of a deal. But sometimes you don't want your sneakers or sneaker wedges that snug. So these are pretty cool. I did have to go a half a size bigger when I purchased these. I usually wear a 6 in most sneakers, and I got these in a 6.5 or 37 for, you know, European sizes, I think. But yes, these are so fabulous. This is my little treat to myself because they look so cute on Heart. She posted a picture of these on Instagram as well, and I told her, I was like, you little enabler, you're an enabler, Heart, because these are so cute. But they're very nice for those days where you just want to throw on something casual. Like, I could wear it with this outfit and not have a problem with it. There's a lot of cosmetics at Target in a while, so I went a little cray-cray. Not to the point where I think I picked up just everything in the world I wanted, but I got stuff in, like, additional shades that I thought I needed to try. Of course, I can always try to return it later. I picked up an extra shade of the CoverGirl 3-in-1 Stay Fabulous Foundation, which originally I picked one up at Target as well. I picked both of these up at Target but separate days. And I did just record a review on this, so it would be up soon if it's not up already. Picked up additional shades in a product. I picked up additional shades in some of L'Oreal's True Match products. I already own both of these things, but in one shade darker, which that shade is more for me like when I'm really tan in the summer. I usually wear W4 in the summer, so I picked up W3 for the rest of the year. I also have a really old review of this up if you're interested, which I'll link down below. And I also picked up the W3 powder. Same reason, because W4 is just a little too dark. I really, really love the L'Oreal True Match powder. I talked about it in one of my monthly favorites before, but it's a really good drugstore powder. And then I got some of the new Maybelline Clean Express makeup removers. I heard good things about this on Instagram, so I figured why not. Even though I do love me some Neutrogena wipes, I figured I would give this a shot because I heard it works really, really well. So I picked up the wipes and then I picked up the liquid remover, and I wanted to see if it could compare or maybe beat my Holy Grail eye makeup remover, which is by Sonia Kashuk, which I also pick up at Target because Target is the only place that sells it. This isn't new or anything like that. I've been using this for years now, and this is the Remove Eye Makeup Remover, and it takes off everything. Waterproof mascara, waterproof eyeliner. It just gets everything off so easily. and this is why I love it so much, but it is like $10 and you get 4.75 ounces. And this is 4 ounces, so less than an ounce under how much is in here. And it's supposed to be really good from what I hear from people. It's supposed to get even waterproof mascara. I haven't tried it yet. We'll see. And it's supposed to be not as greasy. It's supposed to be oil-free. Generally, they both are just like the same thing, like the ones that you have to shake up. But we'll see how that goes. Because if anything, I'll be saving myself like $4 or $5 if I end up switching to this instead and not really losing that much product for it, if it works out like that. But I don't know. Nothing has beat my Sonia Kashuk remover in years. Now I picked up two new things from Garnier. I don't know really how you're supposed to say it, but I picked up their BB cream again. If you haven't seen me do a review on the Garnier BB cream, I have one up. It's a 3-in-1 review with the L'Oreal, Maybelline, and the Garnier BB cream. But this one is the new oily skin, or combination oily skin formula, which a lot of people told me to try out and review because this one is supposed to be a lot better. So as much as I'm just over the whole BB cream phase, I was like, it wouldn't be bad to review it. And I'm kind of interested in seeing if it does vary at all compared to the other formula I tried. And then I picked up their under eye concealer, what is it called? Anti-dark circle roller. It has like a little metal ball thing. I saw good reviews about this as well. I've always been curious about it. It's like $5 or $6, so I figured I would just try it for once. I am wearing it today and I really don't see a difference. Like after I blended it away, it looked just the same like as if I wasn't wearing it. I don't know. Today was just my first time trying it though, so I might try it in different techniques, maybe with different brushes and stuff like that. But it glides on really, really smooth. It's weird that there's only one shade. It's only one shade for everybody, which is kind of odd. The thing I think makes it like anti-dark circle or anti-puffy eye, I guess, is because the ball inside of this thing is metal. It gets kind of messy, but if you can see that. It's a metal ball. You just kind of roll it under your eyes. And because it's metal, it gets really, really cold. So when I put it on, I was like, ooh, the concealer was really, really, really cold. But I haven't seen any, you know, difference after I blended it away. But we'll see how that goes. So that was my hopefully decently quick little collective drugstore clothing cosmetic haul. Hopefully you guys enjoyed seeing it. I do plan on doing like a my favorite foundations video soon. And then maybe my favorite eyeliners and such. That'll probably be like the next little mini series I'm going to do. I still have to film that tutorial and pick out a name from the giveaway that I just ran on my January favorites. But there are a lot of things hopefully coming out this month. So I will get to working on all that stuff. Hope you guys enjoy seeing everything. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in a later video.